Hi everyone, Chef Patty here with AvMed Health and welcome. Today we are gonna make a healthy chocolate chip banana cookie. So instead of making a whole chocolate chip banana bread, we're gonna make it into cookies. So it's gonna be like really soft, just like a banana bread with all the mushy banana and chocolate chip. But we're making it into cookies and we're making it healthy because I'm using almond flour. And I'm also using rolled oats. So watch and see, it comes together rather quickly. I have a ripe banana. So the good thing about this recipe is that you can actually just divide it in half. The original recipe calls for two bananas. I divided it in half because I made a batch earlier. And then now I'm just gonna do the other half. So one banana, nice and ripe. The riper the banana, the easier it is to mash. So I like to mash my banana first, make it nice and soft, kind of like a puree. And that way when you add your egg and the rest of your ingredients, it just comes together much easier. So I've got my banana. And if you want it a little stronger, like a little more banana flavor, then you can add maybe another half, but I feel like this is a great balance. One egg going in my bowl. Okay, a little vanilla. And I'm always like a heavy pourer when it comes to vanilla. Love vanilla, but you can use maybe about a half a teaspoon of vanilla. And I'm using coconut oil. Instead of using like canola or butter, I'm using coconut oil, and the coconut with the vanilla and the oats and all of the flavors go well. Mwah! Perfect. Okay, now these are my wet ingredients. Just gonna combine them all just like this. So you just wanna stir until combined. Okay, this looks good. Now we can add the rest of our ingredients, which is our dry ingredients. And traditionally, the reason why you do two separate bowls, wet and dry, is that when you're using like an all-purpose flour, you never want to overmix. And in this case, we're not using all-purpose flour, but it just makes it easier to combine your ingredients if you do it in batches. So I've got all of this completely done. Now I'm just gonna sprinkle my almond flour, my oats, and I'm using rolled oats. And then I've got coconut flakes. I'm just gonna sprinkle these. I'm using unsweetened coconut flakes. Love this stuff. About a half a teaspoon of baking powder. About another half a teaspoon or a teaspoon of ground cinnamon. And I always use a pinch of salt on my desserts or anything sweet for that perfect balance. And now all we're gonna do is stir, and it just comes together really quickly, very easy. And it's gonna be a little loose, but that's fine. Okay, this is all done. The last thing are our chocolate chips. And you wanna add the chocolate chips at the end, because all you have to do is fold them. We don't need to like overmix them, no need. So the recipe calls for about 6 ounces, a little less than a cup of chocolate chips, but you can use a little less, a little more. You can use dark chocolate chips, whatever you prefer. And that's it. Everything has been mixed. All we have to do now is put it on a sheet pan. I like using a cookie scooper. I have one right here. And I am going to I always scoop and then kind of like level off so they can all be the same size. So I have a culinary camp that I teach during the summer for kids, and they love, this is what we call our scoop and level method. So we scoop and we level, make it nice and even, and I am putting it on my sheet pan, and we're gonna bake these cookies for about 14 to 15 minutes, and they're gonna be like all puffy, so good. You're gonna see, I'll finish this later. I've got a batch that I made earlier, and here are our cookies. They're so good. They're soft, they're yummy. You can even have these not only as a dessert or a snack, but you can even have these for breakfast. So enjoy, guys. I will see you soon. And here you go. I hope you love this recipe. Mwah! Ciao.